B-Monster Laboratory here. Today I have an 8x8 LED matrix, and today we're going to take a look at LED animation by putting a pair of eyes on two of these using Arduino Uno. After reading through some of the forums, I saw some confusion around the 8x8 LED matrix, so even if you are an absolute beginner, I'm going to show you exactly what you need, how to connect it, and the libraries that make this really easy to connect. And today our animation is going to be a pair of eyes using two of these. Let's get started. Well, for this project, you don't need a whole lot of components. So for this one, I'm using the Elegoo Uno microcontroller. You can use a Mega or any board. I'm using the male to female wires, jumper wires, to connect my microcontroller to my first matrix. And I'm using some female to female wires to connect the two matrices together. And I'm using the just a standard 9-volt plug, which I'll plug into my microcontroller to give it some power. And I'll also use two of the 8x8 matrix modules. When you pull the LED panel here off of the module, this is what it looks like. You've got 16 pins on the back here and then 64 LEDs on the front. And that's the number that's on most of these. You'll buy online. I bought this on Amazon. And this is the back. And this is the chip. And there may be multiple chips used for this. I don't know. But the most popular one is the MAC7219. That's the one that that most of the time you'll see in these displays. And when you get it, you may have to do some soldering. For instance, I had to solder the headers on here. And if I did it again, I would solder straight headers on. I don't like the idea, if I'm combining them together, of having the right angle headers. It may be good in some cases, but just be aware that there may be some soldering involved. Now, if you're looking for the data sheet for this particular module, you can go to components101.com. They really give you anything, probably most everything you want to know about this module, including the voltage specifications. So just know that this is a 5-volt maximum component. And if you scroll down here to the bottom, you've got data sheets on all the other components in this module. You can click on the component data sheet red tab right there. Now here's the back of the module with the data pins. Now be sure that when you're connecting multiple modules together, the first module data out pin will be connected to the second module's data in pin. You want to connect that in the correct order. Well, let's go ahead and put all of our jumper wires on our headers, and then after that we'll connect the two display units to our microcontroller. You may notice when I plug it in, one is blinking and one is not. So we'll take a look at that here in just a minute. Now I've already got these libraries on my IDE. They're already installed, but let's say that I don't have them. The first thing I would do is go up here to Tools, go down to Manage Libraries, and up here in the search bar, you want to type in md_max72xx to download that. And then from here, you want to install it. You also want to make sure that you have the most up-to-date version right there. So I've already installed it, as you can see. But if you need to download any other libraries, you do the same thing. You go here and you do a search for it, and you install it from here. Now let's go ahead and close this out. And we'll go up here to File, go down to Examples, and then if you scroll down to the bottom, you will see the md_max72xx. And from there, you can go up here and select Eyes. It'll open up a new IDE window for you. And if you see right here, the hardware type, it may have Parola. Mine is FC16_HW for hardware. It may be IC station. You just need to know what it is. And there's a way to find that out. I'll show you in just a second. Down here in Max Devices, I have two, so I'm going to put two there. And you want to make sure that these pins are at the correct location on your microcontroller. And then that's really all there is to this code. It's already ready to go for you. So we'll flip over here to the other screen, and we'll go ahead and upload our code. And it should light up, but if you see some weird activity, like just a couple dots lighting up on your one of your displays, it could be a connection issue, which I found out. After a while, I figured out that my jumper wire had a bad connection, but once they're solidly connected, and if your solder joints are good, you should get some activity such as this. I just need to hit the reset button here, and it should be good. There it is. And that's what it should look like. And of course, you got to flip the eyes over the right way, but this is what it looks like right now. This is the bad jumper wire that has bad connection. If you're still having trouble getting it to work, you can go back to File, click on Examples, open up the MD-MAX72XX file library, and then go up to Hardware Mapper. And then you want to open that up. This may help determine what hardware you have. And once the code is open, go up here and open the serial monitor. If this doesn't appear on your serial monitor, upload the code and then go back and reopen your serial monitor. Once you're in here, scroll down to the bottom, and you can see that it's going to carry out a series of tests to determine which hardware you have. And at the bottom it says enter Y when you're ready to start. So hit Y, enter that into the text field up above, and then hit Send, and it'll begin diagnosing your hardware to determine what you have. Now, after answering a series of yes or no questions based on the blinking patterns that appear on your display, it'll give you the hardware type. So it gave me a hardware type of IC station, but when I put it in the code, I use FC16_hardware, or HW, and that seems to work much better than IC station. So this may work for you, it may not work for you, but at least it tells you whether your board is communicating with the displays, which is very helpful if you're having trouble getting this thing up and going. So at this point, if you still can't get it to work, you should probably go back and check your solder joints. If you soldered components in, use a multimeter to check those joints. Who knows, you may need to re-solder some of those components in. Now here I've included a schematic in case you need that.
Well, that's all I have for today. I hope this was very helpful to you. As always, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you again very soon.